was using his options very well. Alistair committed maybe a little bit too hard to some things, and maybe didn't commit enough to certain situations. I think that's... like, his advantage state was good. And obviously you don't want to like try and combo Snake for too long, because you don't know, pulling grenade is frame one.
Oh, lovely, okay.
And if you hit the grenade, it explodes and you both take 10. So, comboing Snake is a pain, because if you're not completely frame tight, the grenade comes out and then it's like a neutral reset.
Right.
But we're going into Smithereen, my goat. I imagine this is going to be... I think this is going to be Lucas Vob. And the reason is, Snake's grenades can get energy projectiles technically when they explode. Which means they get absorbed by Lucas's downbeat, which is like the big blue ball you might have seen. And he heals a lot from them. And he heals even more from up smash. Snake up smash is like a mortar that comes up and down. And it heals like 30% if you can juice it.
Alright, well, you were right on the raw prediction.
Yeah, so he stopped playing Snake into it because he finds it frustrating to actually have to fight an even matchup rather than just cheesing everyone. So the cheese lord that he'd be, he will play another top tier and just wall Lucas out with a huge rob nair and crazy rob like combos.
He's like, his only weakness. He's in the jump like he's got three weaknesses. He's large, he's very big, and he's a very large land.
Yeah. Those are pretty much all anyone has to say about Bob, because he's good at everything else.
Yeah.
He's got crazy fast options, he's got crazy slow options,
he's
got great approach, he's a great camper, he's got great setup, he's got crazy kill power.
He's really every archetype, he gets like mad, he goes off
of
grab.
Yeah, he can kill off grab, he can kill off... he doesn't actually have a true zero to death off grab. From zero.
Damn, that's surprising.
Which is a tragedy. A really good character would.
They should buff
off. Yeah. The Lucas forward smash reflect, it's like a very MMS bat. So it's the same company. Except Lucas doesn't have as well. Bob does have his true zero to death off falling nair, which is the world's biggest move and also minus two. Which is completely unpunishable to every character. Oh, not quite getting the combat extension, but down to imagine actually giving a little bit of advantage. Spot dodging against Lucas is so scarf because every single move seems to hit a million times.
Yeah.
So it's like, you can spot dodge, but there's always more coming. Yeah. So that was just a right one. Crazy high percent of Smithereen here. Truly, Rob can't kill. His one weakness. His throws will kill now. In fact, throws killed 70% of them. Up air kills the massive, like, extremely active spinny move. Nair will eventually kill, although it's not like the craziest kill move because it's a combo move normally. If it was lower percent, that offer combo would kill itself about a bajillion times. Yeah, you'll see Lucas doing weird things, and it's hard to explain them all because he has so many mechanics. After playing Lucas so many times, I kind of have them all down, but it's just there's just so much. So you'll see his forward air, that kick that he does in front of him, has a blue ball on the foot. And that's the sweet spot, and it's ludicrously strong, and his minus is like 3. Because it's got so much like shortstop. Not shortstop.
Even Lucas on those campus has like a game.
Yes, so the snake that he does in the air, that's his air. On the ground when he does the snake, that's just his grab.
Right.
So it's not a great grab, although it's very long. And you also have like 4 kill throws. But in the air, it's this crazy, crazy move. Part of the reason it's crazy is because you can double jump cancel it, which is where he does some very weird momentum shifting. He rises and then falls instantly with his air.
Oh, I see that, yeah.
It combos forever because it's basically set up that It kill confirms, it comes into itself, and also it's completely safe. Unfortunately, it's very mechanically hard to execute.
Yeah, it could be an infinite, but it's true.
Yeah, it's an infinite on the like a stage that doesn't have limits, but it's moving along.
Oh, right.
But it will true combo to itself and bust the stage. It true combos into itself and bust the stage, so very, very strong move, but it's. The use cases for it can be hard to set up, and it's playing perfect with the momentum cancel one. So he won't always be doing it in his draw. Although when he's playing hard as well, we'll see that.
You can jump cancel tether?
Yes, and he'll do that a lot. Smithereen's movement off stage gets kind of crazy sometimes. And it can be difficult to even keep track of all the options that he's using. He'll use a combination of B reverses, down B reverses, tether cancels, Lucas is a really weird big double jump. The double jump cancels sometimes. And also he's got the upbeat that is the next one, but it goes forever and doesn't kill a tether. You are dead.
Alright. Is that game one to the
song? That was, yep, game one to the song. Zob, as they call it. Checking controller battery, making sure that everything's alright. Oh, there's a frame of delay if you have this pro wired connection on when you plug it in. So you have to turn it off, that way it's Bluetooth connected, and then you can charge it in the Switch without having it be the wired connection.
Weird.
Very weird. How you doing, Harvey? 102 Zinger at the moment, and then the winner fights me. Zinger Alistair. It was 3-1 to Zinger. The wired connection is better for bigger tournaments to eliminate interference. Yes. Apparently, when there's a ton of Pokons around, the Bluetooth can kind of get confused and you'll drop inputs and get weird stuff going on. And then it kind of accept the one frame of delay for your inputs to be real. So I've heard people say that, yeah. And with a platform that can extend even more. That's cool. And also his head's invincible when he does it, so it's a really good move. It's a little bit small, so small moves. And yet so well. Except for Rob, it's all the video doobies. It's so hard to punch that now out of shield. It's technically punishable. Hopefully that's okay. That was the Lucas up smash. It's one of the laggiest moves in the whole game.
It's like kills.
Oh, it kills. It is like frame a million.
Right. But if you get like a shield right, how are we talking?
We're talking 30.
Oh, okay.
There's also frame one invincible.
Yeah, that's happened to me before. Right? Violet down B, and then it's just armored through the entirety of it.
Yeah, no, Lucas has a lot of weird things. If you realize how much crazy stuff this guy does, I think that was bad DI on up throw. I'm pretty sure he's supposed to DI up throw that glitch, and that was a poor DI, but I'm not 100% certain, so that's what I'm doing. It's also completely safe, so you can't punch it. I'd really be able to out to catch the landing. You can go for that read at high percentage probably. Ooh!
Oh, why?
Lucas' down smash is crazy. It is huge, it's got 3 hits. It's got no end lag at all.
Alright, cool.
And it's also the size of the moon. Unless you get an extension using the back air spike so that he goes back onto the ground and you can keep going. He's a little bit sick nasty. The safest option was just to put it up there, but Smithereen is addicted to Source, and this is the only move that sometimes loses. Dead freeze. I'm glad that Lucas isn't committing his double jump yet. But he does, and he makes the call out with a silky smooth forward air. I like that. 1-1 now. Really great precision. That whole last stock was just really well executed.
Like I saw when they were off stage, mm-hmm. and then like a double jump up air, and I was like, oh, that's like a double jump back. Echo after that, isn't it? Because I saw like one clip of just a fantastic Echo, 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 Echo.
Yep.
And then I was like, okay, well now that you've done that, you're going to go for it on stage for the rest of the game, which back air.
Yeah.
That's like the condition where it's like, oh, that was saucy. I wonder if I can actually hit that.
The thing is, I think aerial off-air into back air is not true. You have to do a landing off-air.
Oh, god.
And then it true combos into
the
back
air. Up-air was just something.
Off-air back air, he'll go for it, and he went for it there because it would extend the combo even further.
Like offstage, while recovering.
Yeah.
Random-ass up-air, and I was very confused.
Yeah, so because recoveries take time to start up, sometimes up-air back air will be like true, and that like, what are you going to do about it?
Got it.
And that's probably what happened to ICK, because Bowser up-air doesn't start instantly. You can combo out of that off-tail and see not reacting to that. Is that dead? Oh my god. Ness IB is such a heinous thing to go with that. Yeah, you've got to get a lot off it here to even it up. No, nah, I messed it up. Oh, if you got the gyro to hit there, there's probably another side B and it would have killed. Oh no, Rob kills has an incredible cheese factor.
I'm a big fan of Rob's spot.
The little arm flail? It's extremely active. The juice. So yeah, you'd think you'd get punished for being that down smash that leg and having it not hurt. But no, there's no attack. So that nair is technically unsafe. The difficult thing about it, oh good DR, that up air has a very weird thing where it can send an either left or right, depending on what side the last hit is.
Okay.
And if you DI incorrectly, like if it sends you left and you DI right, you'll go straight upwards and die at like unbelievably early percent. We're talking 80 off the top. But if you get it right, you won't die until like 160. But it's actually like a Mario Party mini game. You kind of just have to guess. Oop, and the toes, the neck, the sweet spot forward air. Very solid deficit though. I'd be surprised if anything can make a comeback here. Just because Rob is actually, like, Lucas is amazing at gifting people early. But Rob's has pretty much an infinite recovery.
Right.
And it's kind of heavy. So I don't imagine this is going to go anywhere other than it's using our slowly picks up hits until he gets some kind of weird kill. Using any of Rob's suite of kill moves. Good gyro coverage for the tether. I would have thought Berry was the better option there. Berry up air or Berry up smash was pretty safe to kill, but I guess Zinga doesn't even want to take a risk because he wants to put in some kind of disadvantage. I don't know. I doubt it.
Okay, is it death?
Yeah. It totally could. Slytherin is sick nasty. 1-2. Those were sour spots, so they didn't quite come with the link that he wanted to. Okay. So that is 2-1 to the Zob.
Lucas! Rob!
Ooh, jabbing out of the combo screen. Dush. Cool, okay, he's having the 2% frame there. Okay. And it's good to me that this game is going to stay so much more in this matchup than the previous game I've seen him go today. So, like, sometimes he's like, I'm gonna deal a million damage to you from one hit. And sometimes he's like, I'm gonna do random hits here and there, and eventually you'll die.
Yeah.
It just seems to be these two modes that he enters. That's the Zed that I'm talking about. It's kind of like a weird little thing, but it's got a lot of hits on and no end lag. I try to catch the normal getup, but he normal getup shield with one frame of vulnerability, and multi hit sometimes just not be active for that frame. It's kind of just like a yeah, kind of thing. He does recover here if he's not interrupted. He might recover here, he goes far. Yeah, I think he's still got it. It goes far. Oh, the neutral air dodge into spot dodge. He's scared, he's terrified. But he's holding onto his stock still, somehow. That was down tilt. When Lucas just starts hitting you with like these tiny little weird hits, you can do another one. I think I've had enough. He's gonna get to kill off him. What are you doing, Severin? He's always cooking. You just can't stop him from cooking.
Yeah.
I've tried. I'm like, here's how you play Smash Ultimate. He's like, no. I'm busy cooking. What even was that? What was that meeting? Like, in an alternate universe, it hits, and I think he's a genius. This is the third time. You aren't ahead anymore. And now you've got to actually recover against Rob. Just down there. What are you doing, Rob? No. This is probably a side B here if he's got the balls to go for it. No, really nice option. Ooh.
Okay.
Lucas forward tilt is a real move. That shit kills crazy early. And it's like super quick. One, two, three, four, five. Oh, he's so sick, Nasty. Okay, 74%.
There is
oh.
A rat from Trolling Remy from Ratatouille. That is smithereens.
Yeah, actually. Being wise to the fact that down tilt forward smash is not true. Actually, just spot dodged there. Wouldn't have killed regardless, but. Probably back at that actually or something with a true punish, but get some weird follow-up hits. See these like movement options that he just does off stage, it's so hard to catch him. And like, Lucas is not going to be particularly good off ledge, but Smithereens are really creative. Thanks a lot. He's just doing these tiny little taps on shield, it's like okay. No, no, that's silly. All right, 2-2, game 5.
Lucas wins! Huh? Yes, it's better than the rival control.
Start the battle! Lucas!
Oh yeah, he's got ice. He's not here to play, he's got ice.
Three, two, one, go!
Advising that if you don't get the double jump cancel, it's not a great combo at all because he's gonna like sort of floatily land down. The reason why the double jump cancel is so good is because it goes down straight away.
I'm thinking of Vanessa Lucas.
Right.
It's because Absa has Mewtwo and then Vanessa Lucas.
Yeah, so this is game 5. And it's close, it's even. Oh, nice parry of the Crimson. Not quite. Slightly lofty, I did kill there, but. Yeah, sour spot on the forward smash, unfortunately. Oh, and not quite getting the Gee. It's hard to get Rob's recovery, but that was like almost a turn to get that down there. Yep, timing mix up on the landing. Oh, that little down tilt that he does on your shield is like, it's super safe. And it's super hard to recognize exactly what it is. So getting the correct punish on it is difficult. Oftentimes people will jump out and he'll follow it up with like a forward air and just hit you in the air. He just kind of knocks at your door a little bit with weird moves like, what are you doing? Oh my gosh, it didn't kill him. Good DI, not dying off the side of the car. Rising Nan Florida. So the poopies. Great, freeze. Mash just good enough. I bet he actually went as hard out for that. He goes pretty close to the ledge. Well, I'm not getting a tech chase. I would have loved to see a proper tech follow up.
The parries on the middle games.
Yeah, I'm not sure that I love them because, they don't really give you any advantage. So while it's like stylish to like show off that you can, the Robo Beams don't really do shield damage anyway. So you're just giving yourself 3 frames of advantage while taking a bit of a risk that you miss the parry.
I was also doing like on reaction to start action, that's
cooler. And that actually has some more utility. Although it's pretty hard to do, I would imagine.
Yes.
Even though the reflection comes out before the hitbox, it's still, oh, the support doesn't kill. Up throw not gonna kill. I think I love that landing with Matt. He's been a little bit less predictable with it, which has been nice recently. But he's still not dead, but I was hoping.
I feel like Robo Beam comes back faster than before.
Yeah, there's three different variants of it.
No, but like just like the fully charged one, I always thought it would just like take a long time.
Yeah, no, it's pretty common. It doesn't really kill is why, so it's like it's an amazing like we're playing long range, but I'm still doing really well to him.
Right.
But it doesn't, it's not like a charge shot where it's like, wins the game on its own.
Okay.
I don't know exactly how long it takes. It's 20 seconds.
Okay, alright.
So it's like a decent amount of time. Yeah, it's because it keeps recharging when he's in disadvantage instead. So you do it like after a big long edge guard sequence, you don't realize how much time has passed in game. All good edge guard sequence. I'm excited. This could be it. Okay, Lin Zeng, I get back to stage with the Nair. Finding that's going to be too safe to actually punish. Yep, he takes possession of the super plug up stone easily. Okay, take that gyro back. Okay. You can still pick it up, yeah, but while it's spinning on the ground, if you walk into it, okay, you win some doors. What are you doing? Oh my gosh, if this comeback, he's got lost his double jump, but his recovery routes are still clean. Long distance pressure here. Knock at the shield. That's what I talked about. The down throw on shield. Drop shield, strike 5 punches.
Oh,
the down spin. Oh, and it finishes it off. So nice. Wow. Okay. Smithereen.